terrestrial animals. So terrestrial means land. So terrestrial means land. So the animals which live on the land are called terrestrial animals. The animals which live on the land are called terrestrial animals. For example, so the examples for the terrestrial animals are lion, tiger, and wolf. And also we have seen some animals in our villages on roadside like cows and buffaloes, etc. All these are examples for terrestrial animals because all these animals live on the land. And they have some special features, that means they have some adaptations in their bodies to survive on the land, to survive in their habitat. So what are some special features and what are the adaptations are? So these have a strong legs. So these animals have strong legs. So by using these strong legs, so we can move for longer distances in search of their food. So all these living organisms need food. For search of their food, they have to move longer distances. That's why for moving longer distances, the legs have some special features, that are the legs are very strong, so that they can able to longer distances without any tiredness. And also these strong legs help these animals to run also, to and escape from the enemies and to run very speedily. So children, so this is about terrestrial animals. And again, these terrestrial animals are again classified into two types. So these terrestrial animals are classified again into two types. And the first one of terrestrial animals is, what is the first one? So if you take terrestrial animals, so these are classified into two types. The first one is, so among terrestrial means land, and there are two types of lands. So especially the two types of lands are, so the first one is deserts. The first one is deserts, and the second one is polar regions. That means ice cold regions. Polar regions. So children, here the land habitats, especially the terrestrial animals, so again classified into two types, so based upon the land. So there are two types of land on the earth. So one is deserts and other one is polar regions. So the animals which live in deserts and the animals which live in polar regions. Now discuss about so the animals which live in deserts, and next we will discuss the animals which live in polar regions. So first we will discuss the animals which live in deserts. And the animals which live in deserts have some adaptations to survive in those climatic conditions. So if you take deserts, so the temperature is very high. That means the temperature is very hot. So there will be more temperature. And also the availability of water is very, very less. So the water is not available. So no water in the desert. So the animals which live in the deserts have some adaptations, or they will adopt some features to survive in these climatic conditions. That means they to survive in the deserts. So what are the animals that live in the deserts? Example, camel. So the animals which live in deserts are, all we know that camel and some snakes. So desert snakes and some rats. So these are the some examples which live in deserts. So if we take a camel, so all we know about camel, how the camel will be. So have you ever seen camel? So the camel is a very large sized animal, and it is grown up to a very height, and it has a thick skin. So children, in camel the skin is very thick, so as to bear that very hot temperatures. So in deserts the temperature is very high, so that's why it has, the camel has a thick skin, and it can bear that very high temperatures with the help of that thick skin. And all we know that the camel will be called as the desert sheep or sheep of desert. So the camel will be called as sheep of desert. So children, so the water is less available, and how the camel will survive in the deserts? So for this purpose, so there will be some adaptations in the body of the camel. So what is that adaptation is? So the camel can live up to 10 to 15 days without water. So the camel can live up to 10 to 15 days without water. How is it possible? So we cannot live even one day without water. But how camel will live up to 10 to 15 days without water? So there will be some arrangement in their body. So there will be some arrangement in the body of the camel that it can store the water. So in its hump. So it can store its water in the body. So it can use that water if there is no availability of water. So this is the one special arrangement which is made in the body of the camel. So that's why the camel can live up to 10 to 15 days even though there is no water. So it can store its water in its stomach, and in its stomach there will be a special arrangement. And also it can live up to 10 to 15 days even though there is no food. So how is it possible? So children, if you look at the camel, so it will has a hump. So what is it? Hump. So if you see its hump, it will be look it as a bulge. So it will be look as in the shape of a curved shape, and it is as bulge. So what is it contains? So the camel eats food and it converts into fat, and it will be stored in its hump. So the camel will stores the eaten food in the hump in the form of fat. So the camel can live up to 10 to 15 days even there is no water, and even though there is no food, because it can store water in its stomach, and it can store its food in the form of fat in its hump. So if there is no food after 10 to 15 days, then it will reuse the fat as a food present in its hump. That means, so it can use the fat present in the hump as a food even though there is no availability of food. So children, so these are the adaptations in the camel to survive in the desert. That means to survive in the hot climate conditions which does not have water. And also, children, if you observe the feet of the camel, so there will be a broad pads at the bottom of their feet. So what does they have? A broad pads. So they have a broad pads at the bottom of their feet. So these broad pads prevent the legs of the camel to go deep into the sand. So if we walk, so can we walk speedily in the sand? No. So and we cannot walk speedily in the sand, and we cannot run in the sand, because our feet will go deep into the sand, and the sand will avoid, or the sand will prevent us to walk very speedily, to run very speedily. But whereas in camel, so it can walk very speedily, even it can run even in the sand. How is it possible? Means there will be a special arrangement, a special adaptation in the camel. That is, it has a broad pads like pillow-like structures at the bottom of its feet. This broad pads, this pillow-like structures prevents the legs of the camel to go deep into the sand. And that's why it can walk very speedily, and also it can run very speedily in the sand. So this is about deserts, and also about the animals which live in deserts, and the adaptations which are taken in the animals which live in the deserts. So now children, the second type of terrestrial animals. So what is the second type of terrestrial animals? That is polar regions.